headed east on Wolf Road in Nassau, Bahamas, just past Market Street, you will hear the sounds and see a music shop on the northern side of the street that will take you back in time to the late 60s and early 70s and all the way forward to 2020. A business that seems to have been delicately preserved in a time warp when there were turntables, record players, albums, 45s, 33s, cassette, and 8-track tapes. The Supremes, The Temptations, The Jackson 5, Diana Ross, James Brown, Al Green, Otis Redding, Dionne Warwick, Ray Charles, Aretha Franklin, Michael Jackson, Stevie Wonder, Marvin Gaye, Diana Ross, Tina Turner, you name it. Sydney's Record Shop has it. Meet Mr. Sydney Stubbs of Sydney's Record Shop, 200A Wolf Road.
Sydney Stubbs.
Okay, you have a middle name?
Anthony.
Sydney Anthony Stubbs.
Yeah.
Okay. And what is your date of birth?
Well, 1952, the 11th October.
October 11th, 1952. Mm-hmm. Where were you born?
I was born right here in Princess Margaret Hospital.
Okay. And who was your mother?
Anna Stubbs.
Anna?
Yeah.
Anna Stubbs. And your father?
Austin Stubbs.
Austin Stubbs.
Yeah.
Okay. Do you know who your grandparents were?
My grandparents? My daddy mother, Victoria Barnaby. Victoria Barnaby.
Okay.
That's my daddy mother. My mother was Lula Wiley.
Where were your parents from? Where was your mother from originally? Was it Nassau?
No.
Where did
she? Castle, Lutra.
Oh, she was from Lutra. Yeah. Your dad?
Cat Island, Dumfries, Cat Island.
Okay, did you have brothers and sisters?
Yep, but I had 8 children, 4 boys, 4 girls. My brother older than me, he's on the porch. He got 1 leg.
Okay.
His name is Clifford Stubbs. And Marie died, that's what we want to call him. We got Sherry, Janice, Phyllis, Ian, Derek. That's about it right there.
So where did you fall? You were first, second, third?
I second.
Oh, you were the second, yeah. So you were one of the older children?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Where did you grow up? In which part of Nassau?
I grew up in Lutra for a little while.
Mm-hmm. So went to school there. Did your parents move there? Or you?
No, my mother was still here. I went to grow up with my grandparents.
Okay.
My great-grandparents and my grandparents. Mm-hmm. I grew up with them. I come back probably when I said 14.
Do you remember much about Lutra? Which part?
Green Castle. But I remember much about
it. Do you remember the house you lived in? What it looked like?
The house is not there. I need a permanent house there now. It's a total water and all that. Mm-hmm. Go to the well, all kind of stuff.
Did you have electricity back then?
No. Lamp.
You had lamp?
Yes.
And you had
took water from the well.
Is the house still there that you live in?
The permanent house is still there. I call it over yonder.
Okay, so did you finish school there?
No. Yeah. Okay.
And where did you go to school here?
Reston.
Reston, okay. All right. So after you finished high school, what did you
I never went to finish high school.
No, you didn't finish?
No.
Okay.
No.
What grade were you, do you remember?
Ah, boy. What grade was it? I played the drum a lot now, since they don't make me yoga. Drawing a lot. How old I was during that time? Probably 15, 16. But I was big in my age, I was tall.
So what about you said you grew up in Lutra until you was about 14?
No, I was 18.
13?
Yeah.
So where were your siblings? Where were your brothers and sisters?
Right here.
Okay, so only you went?
When I went there, I was only 4 years old. Mm-hmm. And when he looked, I never. Apparently, I never knew my old man like that, you know, till I come back here, because I went there at the age of 4.
And your grandparents, I assume that they have all passed now?
They're all gone.
And what about
they was my mother, because they grew me up. I shared it between the two, my great-grandmother and my grandmother. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, so after you left school here, what did you do?
What I was doing? I was a shoe-shine boy, sell paper, sell peanut, all of that.
And where were you living at the time?
With my mother, right up the road here by Palm Avenue. Okay. You know where the house of labor is? I was living right there. Okay. I used to shine shoes because my daddy been gone. Shine shoes to help with the rest of the kids.
So you made a living doing jobs like that in order to...
I was shining shoes until one time I went on Bay Street shining shoes. The police caught me. My mother had to go to court that Monday. And that Monday they said she must try to get me something to do. I went to Emerald Beach to work as a bread boy. And then I was a bus boy. Cleaned it for a little while.
So then, that part about Bay Street, that's interesting. So you couldn't go on Bay Street to shoot?
And the funniest thing about that, a white police locked me up.
So it was illegal to shine shoes on Bay Street?
But it says I wasn't supposed to be in that area. I was right by the Sheraton, British Colonia. I was in that area.
And how old were you at the time?
I don't know, mostly 14 or almost 15.
You were very young.
Yeah, but I was a hustler.
So you had to go to court?
Yeah, but they just tell after my mother why I was in school and all that problem. She tell me to use old shining shoes to help me because they had no father. Mm-hmm. She had a little job, but that was the back of the help up, me and my brother. Yeah.
So what did your mother do for a living?
Maid. Okay. Had some white people for many years. Called Miss Camp, the Camp family.
Your father?
On Mackey Street.
What did your father do for a living?
My father was working to waterways for a long time, but my father was with somebody else.
Okay, so your mother was a maid, and then you did shoe shining, selling peanuts and everything else, and then you started working at the hotel?
After that.
And you did various jobs at the hotel?
Yeah, and I ended up there leaving. I remember going to Nassau Beach. I was a houseman for many years. I bought a couple of the motels. What are you calling me for?
Okay, so when did you leave the hotel and why?
Leave?
Yeah, you stopped working at the hotel, right? No,
I've been doing it all of my life. I've been doing it 42 years.
So you stayed there until you retired?
No, different hotel, you know, I didn't work one. I went to go at Britannia Beach also, and Lowe's. I don't know if you know anything but Lowe's.
I heard
that. I used to work Lowe's. I've been a couple of hotels I worked. Mm-hmm. You know, my last hotel was Crystal Palace. I worked there for many years in banquet. I was a waiter. I just do private function. Uh-huh.
Okay, so you retired from there then?
Mm-hmm.
And then what? What did you do after that?
I used to do this.
Okay.
I was doing this before I even come into this. I used to sell them. Remember when they had the little cassette tapes? I used to make them up and go sell them. And then I just, one day I was looking for a place to stay because I had moved. So I have known this lady. Was working on the other side of Radisson. You know where Radisson is, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's many years ago. She said, well, if you got a place in Woodford, why you don't go in Woodford and take care of the property first and whatever. I can call my brother. And then I come here and I was here many years.
Okay. All right. So the business is called Sydney
Record Shop.
Were you always in this location on Woodford?
Many years ago. Many, many years ago. Remember the albums? I used to have a record shop. I just sell records. Wasn't no CDs, just cassette and records. I was to be on East Street, down East Street there, not too far. If you go to Andrews Avenue, right on East Street one time ago. It didn't last that long. Yeah.
So is this a record down here?
They put the albums.
Can I see?
Yeah, it's a Bahamian album.
Okay. This is a Bahamian album here?
Yeah.
Okay. So, you started doing the cassette tapes because the cassette tapes was what came after these albums, right?
They come on along the same time.
Okay.
The same time, Motown and all of them.
Mm-hmm.
All
right.
It's
wow,
been
decades.
Yeah, I could play. I could play too. I still could play.
Do you have the actual turntable?
I have a turntable, but it don't lock onto that thing. No, it's over here. But you can't see it right there. I got this thing on top of it.
Okay.
Yeah. That's it. So that I can set play everything right there.
So as the music thing evolved, you then went into CDs, is that it?
Yeah, they're going in the CD. But you know, people still looking for cassette. Mm-hmm. I have people come here every day looking for cassette tape because they still have the machine. I have 8-track player, the real player up there. All of them still working. Mm-hmm. You know, you remember the 8-track, right? The 4-track guy, 8-track. You could roll up in the...
So this is the 8-track
tape? Yeah,
that's
it.
So what's the difference between this and the other one?
Which one?
The smaller.
This one. You could press the button and it shifted the sound. Now a small one, you just got to play it through and spin.
Okay.
And that's...
Morning.
The stereo up there. What they do, like what Motown them used to use with the real thing. Way up top there. That's what I think of something.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, so you started off doing cassette tapes, mm-hmm. and then you had 8-track tapes.
Mm-hmm.
You had albums.
Album, records, 45 records. Or 12 album. You had the big album, you had the small records. See the small records over there?
Oh.
Here the small records.
They call these 45s, right?
45.
Yeah. And these were the 45s?
45s, yeah. Yeah.
And they could still play?
Yeah. I should have had the tape myself. I had it myself, you tell me. At the time, I had a setup who could hear it. Yeah.
So who are your customers? What type of customers do you, who do you cater to?
Miss, you know, more older people, but you have a lot of young people now coming and looking for golden oldie. Now the youngest are coming looking for reggae, dance hall and thing. I do a few of them, not much, but I just deal a lot of old stuff with certain people. You know, but young people is coming and look for them things too.
Mm-hmm.
Plenty of young people, golden old, especially when I go out, because I go to Lucha to sell. You know, they be looking, they won't mix everything. You know.
Okay. So you do movies as well?
One or two, not much. The older movies, like what being up before, all the Sharp, of course 110 Street, Cotton Comes to Harlem, with Sidney Poitier and all, I got all the Sidney Poitier movies. I got all that stuff.
Music.
Music videos over in the corner there. They movies and music video.
Wow, you have quite a collection.
Yeah, Whitney Houston and all of them also. Then we got on top there. See on top of the counter there? No, what's spread on the counter? Right there. Right there. Yeah, they the golden oldies, all the old artists and thing. Was singing, Luda, all of them. They on videos there. People would be coming asking for them too. So I have to keep them. I do a little everything. Boy, I tell you, there's plenty. I almost even forget about all that stuff. Because they did a whole lot of videos in there. They even going in the room they were set up is. And yeah, there's a lot of stuff. But I mean, you know, they ask somebody a lot of questions with that. You know.
So in the room is where you produce the stuff?
Where you do the recording. Have you peeped right there, see?
Right here?
Yeah. Maybe all the burners, in there, do all the thing. And I work from in there. Now I bring in another machine in soon to do a lot of downloading and stuff.
So are you married? Did you ever get
my wife
married?
Just died. Okay. See her right there looking at you.
Okay. Did you have children?
I had 6 kids. I had 4 girls, 2 boys. One of my daughter work in the courthouse when the judge talking with the past typing. She do that. One of Atlantis, she work the BC, that's one for government. And yeah, 4.
What was your wife's name?
Margaret Stubbs. She's worked with education all half her life.
What was her maiden name?
Nottage.
Okay.
She's a Nottage.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. She got from St. Augustine School.
Okay.
Then she from Augustine, she went to Princeville. I met her in St. Augustine many years. In the band, because she was in the band too, but she was in the drill team.
Right.
Yeah. I went to school in Miami too for the band. They sent us away the line, American style, to bring back here. Jackson High School.
What did you do in the band?
I first started with drum, but then I was one. You know, a lot of guys been the Sick and the Police band. I ended up doing that. Okay. That was my thing. Three drum majors. I was the lead drum major, and he had two behind me. It was all right. If you look straight up in the corner, you can see like a band. Now you can see the picture.
Yeah.
Okay, that's the band. It was it.
So, are your children interested in this business today?
My daughter, oldest daughter.
Okay.
But I moved in the shop to Lucha. I put them back in here. But she say, don't care all the music, because she wants to have some music too. But I won't go to Lucha. I'll move back there. Cause I got some property I clean up there now. I can be living up there. And I try to get a shop in Roxanne.
Well, you have to pay something that I doubt you could find anywhere else.
Huh?
You really have a collection?
Yeah, I got a lot. But over there, it's something new. But you, people look the same way. People go around in and asking for the same stuff here, and people over there doing the same thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
And how old are you?
I'm 69. I don't hide that age. Mm-hmm. Ain't much to live to see it.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, I have a lot of younger people who comes in, and some saying they won't get into this type of business too. You know, but you know, everything is modern now. They're doing different things now, you know. So I don't know. But a lot of the young people, they look at the turntable to play record. Every time I look through this door, some young people come and they must see buy turntable. They come looking for records. They come looking, people come from all over, from China, America come here, they buy, carry albums, they carry a whole lot of albums with them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I don't know.
So you sell albums too?
Yeah.
They must be very expensive.
No.
So, but then can do you recreate them?
When you say recreate them?
I mean, if I came in here today and I wanted an album, you just tell me one of what you are?
Yeah, that's what people do, because like I have two or three of for the same CD, people buy it. They're just young people that just come in. I don't know if they do it in the cafe, but they must be upgraded or do something else to it. I know you take some joy in the water, you clean it up, find it. Anything to come from. You tell them, come back in a couple of minutes, and when they come back, it's back in there. This side is gospel, Christmas carol, reggae, young people. Music, say Boys to Men and all of them, that's fine. All your golden oldies at the back.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Otis Redding, Percy Sledge, Kenny Rogers, whoever.
Mm-hmm.
All your old artists up there.
What would you say is the music that people ask for the most?
Mixed golden oldie and mixed reggae.
Mm-hmm.
Old school.
Mm-hmm.
Old dub. You know about old dub? Culture and all that. Well, you know, but the golden oldie, like Percy Sledge, Otis, Teddy, and all of them type of stuff. Sam and Dave, Rita Franklin, Nat King Cole, all of them type of stuff. They want it mixed on a mixed CD. Put it all on one. Baby, we have them here. Yeah.
So how much it costs to do something like that for one?
I tried to work with people, because I said 3 for $10.
Mm-hmm.
And if you buy one, it's $5.
Okay. What about records? What prices do you
charge? People just come in and I'm $3 and
$4. Okay, that's reasonable. Very reasonable.
Yeah.
Interesting.
And clean it all for them too, for the guy. Wipe it in the track, clean it, put it back in the tank.
Mm-hmm.
I tell you, this cover record every different week. In the week time, about 4 days of the week, people come looking for records.
Mm-hmm.
Young people. Yeah, I think when you come again, I got the records and things so you can see them.
Okay.
And the turntable, put them on top there.
Okay.
So you can turn them on for you so you can get them play.
Yeah, it's been decades.
Yeah.
I remember as a child playing records, but boy, that's high school.
You might have been faster, because when we used to be on the block here, around the 70s, we used to be playing all kind of golden oldies, because I was the only person who used to have a little turntable playing golden oldies. Nobody else, it's just me. And I just went on from there.
Mm-hmm.
We saw all our blockers we played. Otis and all different type people like that.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Interesting.
And the funny thing with me, when I get the turntable, somebody must have steal something and hide it. Because we remember when they run past, whoever was around behind them. And I was sitting on my old lady port. This man run there and he'd dig up and put something in the ground and be going there. He had about $300 in the ground. When he get that, and we go and miss, and we go on straight to the shop, they buy this record player. And he's about to kill that player in the block. We saw him and he come back, and he's looking all over the place. And he's just a long time ago, to me, I was young then, when I happened. Mm-hmm. That's how I get into really playing a lot of music and things.
Right.
But it's good though. I always enjoy this song. I'd be right now. I play what I want. Speak outside. Every evening, people, they sit and they well, hear the golden old. Every day, they sit over there, between there and there. Mm-hmm. Same guy in the chair, the guy in over sit down. Mm-hmm. But on Sunday, I play gospel for a while, you see.
Mm-hmm.
Then, come in with a gospel voice.
Yeah, it's nice living in areas like this where you could be entertained.
We don't have no crime in this area yet.
Mm-hmm.
I know. I think that some people that they get drunk, they make noise. You run them home, tell them and go home, go sleep.
There was a liquor store right up there, they closed down there.
Long time. You remember it? The Smith. Yeah, it was right up the road.
Mm-hmm.
It's a tailor shop now.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you remember things then. You remember. When you used to pass, you should see the liquor store?
I guess, but I thought that was recent.
Oh, you mean the one up the road there?
Yeah.
Pabby's?
Yeah.
Oh, that closed down. Well, buy the whole property out.
Okay.
They putting like a hotel room there now.
A hotel?
Yeah, apartments like hotel room. People who come in and they going to put
short-term.
A... Oh, you put a... Yeah, he can put a bar out front. Like a club, you could come in. Sports bar, like all that. He waking and all that.
So you live on the same property?
Yeah, 3 years. I've been here almost 40 years.
40 years?
Because the people who gave me the place, who sent me here, she died. But the brother, he's still living, but he's old. But his wife died, he married again. The whole family, they were very smart.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, right. You know, God is good, he do all things.
Mr. Sidney Stubbs, born in Nassau, Bahamas in 1952, spent his early days in Greencastle, Eleuthera, and then back to Nassau, where he had a determination and a drive to work hard and take care of his family, from shoeshine boy to peanut and newspaper boy, then bread boy and bus boy, and moving on in the hotel career, where he spent 40 years of his life. He started Sidney's record shop in the 70s, and you can still hear the sounds of music emanating from the store's front on Wolf Road, music that has never been surpassed and the remnants of memories from a never-to-be-forgotten past.
When it's cold outside.